Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Trinell from the YTOS, and welcome back to the countdown to Sonic Mania. In this video, we are going to start our adventure with Sonic and Knuckles, which was the direct follow-up from Sonic 3, which we just completed, and we're playing this on the SEGA Vintage Collection. Now, if you don't know what the SEGA Vintage Collection was, it was basically a bunch of I guess you can call them ports of classic Genesis titles. You had the Sonic series, Streets of Rage. You also had like Toe Jam and Earl. They were all brought to the Xbox 360, and I'm guessing they were brought to the PlayStation 3 as well, under this moniker, and re-released for people to play. Now, they were re-released again on the Ultimate Genesis Collection, which I've been playing on previously, but in that version of Sonic 3 and Sonic and Knuckles, they did not incorporate the lock-on technology, meaning that we would have to play both games separately. Now, I didn't want to do that because of obvious reasons. You know, Sonic 3 and Sonic and Knuckles was originally intended to be one full game, and when you got both of them, you got to experience the lock-on technology and play like the full game as it was intended. So that's what we're going to do, and the SEGA Vintage Collection allows us to do that. So we're going to do a little bit of recapping with what happened at the end of Sonic 3, and then we're going to move into what happens during Sonic & Knuckles. Again, we're going to be playing as Sonic and Tails, you know, so we can basically continue from where we left off. So with all that talking out of the way, let's go ahead and get started. All right, so here we go. The SEGA Vintage Collection of Sonic & Knuckles. And when you go to bonus content, it basically gives you all of the options that were available when it came down to the cartridges. So if you connected Sonic 3, you get Sonic 3 and Knuckles. If you connected Sonic 2, you got Knuckles and Sonic 2. And if you connected Sonic 1, you got to play the Blue Sphere Endless. I think it's Endless. I've never beaten it. But you get to play the mini game. It's basically the special stages over and over and over again. I don't know that there's actually an end. And I may try this out, or try all of these out at some point, but we're going to go ahead and get started with Sonic 3 and Knuckles, but we have to do a little bit of recapping, like I stated before, so let's go ahead and get into that. Okay, so at the end of Sonic 3, we defeated the, the giant big arm, or whatever you want to call it. I'm not sure what you want to call it. A few differences. Number one, Tails was not here in the original Sonic 3. This is pretty much playing out the same way it did at the end of Sonic 3 with us falling. And then it shows the death egg falling as well, as you can see. Alright, so now that we have that out of the way, we are here on Mushroom Hill Zone, which is the first zone on Sonic and Knuckles, but this is just a halfway point on Sonic 3 and Knuckles. As you saw, you know, the egg, the death egg fell and landed in this new area, which was in the Sonic and Knuckles like opening cutscene, like title screen, I guess you can call it. And since we're here, we get to, you know, just play through Sonic and Knuckles, and there's a few new things. Like, this cutscene doesn't happen on the standalone game. That's a very unique sprite that I don't think we get to ever see that again. A Knuckles sneaking and creeping around corners like that. Of course, Tails being here is also something unique to the combined Sonic 3 and Knuckles. And as you can see here, we have a special stage ring. Calm down, Tails. Now, Just by looking at it, you can tell it's a little different. I mean, it's glowing all of these like fancy colors. And when we go in here, we are taken to, oh God, what is this place called? The Hidden Palace Zone. And as you can see, there is the Master Emerald. Our Chaos Emeralds scatter and then reappear bigger than ever before. They're now Super Emeralds. So that's what we have here. We have Super Emeralds and a brand new slew of special stages. Now, when you play the game standalone, you don't get to, you know, see all of this. This is only because we are playing the combined Sonic and Knuckles with the Sonic 3 cart. And we get, you know, this extra cool shit. So we're going to do some of these bonus stages and we're going to attempt to get them all. But just be warned, I am not nearly as good at these bonus stages as I am at the ones in Sonic 3. So you may see me mess up a few times. Hopefully not, though, because I don't necessarily know where all of the bonus rings are in this game. Like, honestly, I am a lot less familiar with Sonic and Knuckles than I am with Sonic 3, and it's actually kind of sad how much I don't know about this game. But we're gonna try our very best. I mean, it controls identical to Sonic 3. It's basically just, you know, newer stages or whatever you want to call them. They're different. But I think we are on the right track. The main thing about these is that I just never figured out the route. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can beat most of these by following a particular route. And I think I'm actually doing that now, but I just never knew the route for these bonus stages. Funny story, I actually owned Sonic 3 before, I actually owned Sonic and Knuckles before I owned Sonic 3. That was my phone, by the way. Sorry about that. But I was much younger. I was much younger, and so I never really got the hang of it. It wasn't until I got older where I picked up Sonic 3, and that became Sonic 3 became, you know, my favorite Sonic game. Oh man. All right, so I didn't want to do that, but we did it. All right, so I am looking for the rest of the, there we go, the rest of the piles, because once we get a perfect, that means we have all the rings and we can just get those little random, like, sets of four. Okay, so we have one down there. How do we get there, though? Jesus. All right, here we go. All right, so we are at max speed. Hopefully this is the perfect. Yes, okay. So we have 13 left. If you're getting dizzy, I apologize. Okay, so we got that, bam. Okay, eight more. So two more sets of four. We just gotta find them. Oh God, I do not wanna hit those freaking, those springs. Okay, I think there was one up here. Was there one up here? No. Oh God. Okay, here we go. Bam, bam, bam. Four more. Where could they be? It may have been smart to get the sets of four so I wouldn't have to worry about this, but Oh God. Let's just get the fuck out of here. Oh man, alright, not that way. It has to be up here somewhere. Up here. Where are you? There we go. Got him. Alright. Whew. So we got ourselves our first super emerald. Different than the Chaos Emeralds. my heart is literally racing right now. Because I did not know exactly how to do that. Wow, with the one mans, I will take them. And as you can see, it'll show up at the shrine. There we go. Okay, so we have our first super emerald. And you will notice that since we entered that palace and activated the super emeralds, we no longer have our Chaos Emeralds. You saw in the cutscene, they scattered. So that means we do not have Super Sonic anymore. Which is unfortunate for me because I feel like I really spoiled myself by playing Super Sonic so much in Sonic 3. I mean, I love the Super Sonic transformation in this game because there are ways for you to untransform. And I always thought that was a good thing. You know, you could play through the game as Sonic or, you know, Super Sonic and, you know, change by going through the bonus stages. I love that. But yeah, we're just regular old Sonic now. until we get all the super emeralds. Then we'll have another transformation that we can use, which is even freaking more OP. But we'll cross that bridge when we get there. Mushroom Hill Zone, one of my favorite zones in all of 2D Sonic history. I love this tune. It's just so like jumpy, you know? I don't know, it's just something about it. This zone actually made a return in the 3DS version of, what's it called, Sonic Generations, and it's probably my favorite one in that game as well. Sonic Generations on the 3DS, I mean, it wasn't bad, but it didn't have as much of the feels and nostalgia as the previous or the main game did. All right, so this is another bonus stage. You know what? I think this is new. This isn't in Sonic 3 at all. So this is a Sonic and Knuckles bonus stage, and it's basically you're just trying to get up. You go up, you collect shields, collect rings. And if you wait too long or take too much time, there's an energy bar that will basically just end the bonus stage for you. You can also end it by getting to the top. You hear that noise? That whoop? That was Tails getting caught. I think I might be. Yeah, it's getting closer. That noise means it's getting closer. Uh-oh, it's getting closer. Oh, I can't get that. Yeah, give me that one up. Lots of one-ups. And so, of course, I had to replay all of Sonic 3 in order to get to this point in Sonic 3 and Knuckles, but it's all good. That's why my life count is at freaking 44. Oh, I think that was an emerald. Can we get back up here? Nope, it wasn't an emerald. So we still got our elemental shields. We got some new Batniks. I always hated that guy throwing like the little mushrooms at you. Hate that dude. Yeah, and this was always crazy for me because as a kid, you know, I owned Sonic and Knuckles first. So in that game, you can only play as just Sonic or just Knuckles. And you saw there, I got 300 rings, but I did not get a 1-up. You only get 1-ups for 100 and 200 rings. Once you get 300, the game's like, all right, you're cheating. You don't get a 1-up. I don't know that there's any more bonus stages in this act. I don't think that there are, but I could be totally wrong. Oh God, the mushroom, run! That thing was chasing me. All right, so let's go ahead and get on with this. Lots of loopies. Oh, who's this guy? He can't mess with us because we have the fire shield. But his thing is he just like chops down trees and hits you with the logs or whatever. Give me that. Yo, my score is about to be off the charts. Look at this. 348 rings. It was because of that bonus stage. Alright, so Mushroom Hill Zone Act 2. Oh, we get a little bit of cutscene action. Oh, what's Knuckles up to? No, he's hitting the switch. No! Alright, so now it's fall. It went from like spring to like fall. Like all the leaves are like dying and like brown and stuff. I never understood how I just went up and then like everything was just brown. Yo, Tails, chill, sir. Stop jumping. But yeah, having Tails here for the first time, you know, when I first played this, was like super trippy. You can actually play through this as Tails. And, you know, because in Sonic and Knuckles, Tails doesn't even appear in the game. But in this, with the locked on cartridges, you can play the entire game as Tails. And even get his only transformation in video games. Of course, he has transformations in the comic books or whatnot, but he's only been able to transform once in games, and it's in this one. And it's actually pretty, freaking OP. Get to grab onto these little mushrooms and use like the wind current to ride them up. Just a lot of nostalgia with this game, man. I had so many good times with this game. So many good times. All right, so I'm looking for an emerald. I think that there's an emerald somewhere up here. Let's go through this bonus stage. Oh God, no. Oh God, please don't make me lose my rings, please. All right, we got two. We're out of here. I don't want to be here. Get the hell out of here. Just get out. Just leave. Yeah, we gotta find those emeralds. It's gonna be kind of tough for me just because I'm not. You know, I'm gonna keep saying this. I'm not as familiar with this game, even though I owned it first. Not as familiar with this as I am with Sonic 3. Because again, I played Sonic 3 as like a young adult, so I learned stuff and like remembered where like stuff was. Okay, I think this is an emerald. Here we go. Okay, so again, we're back at the shrine, and another unique thing is that we get to choose which bonus or which special stage we want to do. Prior, you wouldn't get a choice. You know, it would go in a specific order, but now we get to choose where we want to go. Okay, so we are gonna go. I think we just want to go in order from left to right. So let's just go with this one. Hopefully, it doesn't destroy me. Oh my God, this is the only one that I don't know by heart. Okay. All right, so I'm gonna be honest with you guys. I do not know how to beat this one. I never did as a kid. So what I did was I went online and I looked at a tutorial. I had to find out because. As a kid, I never figured this one out. And like I stated before, it's all about knowing the route, and I just never knew the route for this bonus stage. I never knew it. So I looked it up, and I hope and I pray that I'm doing this correctly. Because I honestly don't know. Okay, so we want to go here. Oh God, this was like my worst nightmare as a kid, man. I don't even really need these rings, but okay, we got the perfect. Okay, so it looks like we're on the right track. I just need to be like super freaking careful and all my P's and Q's. Jump. Okay. Okay. Oh my God, are we doing this right? Jump. Oh my God. Oh. Jump. We did it. Oh, it made you go backwards. Oh, that is so trippy. How the heck are you supposed to figure that out? I don't know how you're supposed to figure that out, but we did it. You know, I can't even take full credit for that one. I honestly had to go and look this up prior to starting this recording. I was like, that is the one that I'm not going to be able to figure out on my own. So I had to look that one up. Okay, so we have two super emeralds, which is good. And I think there's one more emerald in this zone. There's one more. Let's not lose our rings. Let's eat that. Yeah, one right here. All right, so let's just hop right back in. And we're actually pretty lucky. That first emerald that we got from the little like cutscene with Knuckles isn't in the standalone Sonic & Knuckles game. So at this point, I would only have one. And like I said before, I don't know where all the emeralds are in this game. So it's a little difficult for me. But we're gonna get through it the best way we can. Okay, man, this is not ringing any bells. This is not ringing any bells, but this looks like a pretty linear. It looks pretty linear. So there might be like one jump. I think that there's like one jump that you have to do. Okay, a few jumps. Okay. Okay, not that way. Yep. Okay. Hopefully I'm doing this right. I mean, there's only but a certain amount of ways you can go. We won't get the perfect because I definitely did not complete a square back there. So hopefully that was not me messing up. All right, we only have six left, so where could they be? Oh God, that scared the hell out of me. I was like, do I jump here? Four more. Bop, 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 bop. Easy. Okay, that was easy. Pretty straightforward. Down to the point. Man, those one-mans are just... they're just giving away the one-ups like it's nothing. All right, we're moving right along. And I think the hardest one is like out of the way. There might be one more that I have trouble with. Okay, there are a few things about this game that I do remember. Tails is just so trippy in this. And I don't know if this is how it works, but normally I always go on the... Oh, God. You go up the left one, right? Till it gets to the top. And if you go off the spring, you get to come up here. I don't know. That's just something I always figured out. We want the fire shield for this one because we are close to the boss. Let's get that checkpoint. And that's Eggman's satellite. And this is probably one of the coolest Eggman fights in the series because you have to like fight him while you're running. It's like a scrolling boss fight, which is always really cool. The Tails get a couple hits in. You can actually kill him or do like the majority of the damage to him before the fight even starts. But I thought it'd be cool to actually fight him. Okay, so that's gonna end it for this first episode. I know there was a lot of explanation going on, a lot of stuff I had to deal with, and I definitely want to thank you guys for tuning in and going through that with me. So with that said, I'm going to go ahead and get up out of here. My name is Trunel. This is the countdown to Sonic Mania, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Peace out.